the universe. An anomalous bluster of bosons and fermions, protons and neutrons all bouncing around in ineffable glory. It's home to many astounding wonders of space and time.
Hey guys, so let's explore one of these cosmic stunners, black hole. Large cosmic bodies like stars are collections of mostly hydrogen and helium atoms. These stars burn up their reserves of fuel and collapse under their own gravity.
In their core, nuclear fusion crushes hydrogen atoms into helium, releasing a tremendous amount of energy, which, in the form of radiation, pushes against the force of gravity, maintaining a delicate balance
between the two forces and keeping the star stable. But as time progresses,
the core fuses heavier elements like carbon, neon, oxygen, silicon, until it reaches iron. Iron doesn't fuse further and hence emits no radiation. It slowly builds up in the center of the star until the balance between radiation and gravity becomes lopsided. The core collapses, and in the fraction of a fraction of a fraction of a second, the star implodes into a supernova explosion. This cosmic phenomenon produces either neutron stars, dense celestial objects made up of subatomic particles called neutrons.
A neutron star is so dense that one teaspoon of its material would have a mass about 900 times
the mass of the Great Pyramid of Giza.
Its density is therefore 100 trillion times that of water. At that density, all the people living on Earth could be fed into that very same teaspoon.
And finally, if the supernova is massive enough, it can produce a stellar mass black hole. When you look at a black hole, you'd be actually seeing the event horizon, a boundary in space-time through which nothing, not even light, can escape. For any information to escape out of the event horizon, it needs to be traveling faster than the speed of light and is therefore impossible.
So, we just see a black sphere reflecting nothing. Now, what is inside a black hole? For the most part, we don't really know. At the center of each black hole,
there exists a singularity, a region of infinite density. Or maybe not. It's like a Schrodinger's cat situation.
You really know the truth? You'll have to pack up those new sneakers your mama bought you for Christmas, take a deep breath, and jump right into a black hole to find out.
Not that it would help, anyways. The experience of time around a black hole is completely different. To an outside observer, you would seem to slow down, freeze in time, and slowly disappear. While from your perspective, you could see the outside world and fast forward, much like seeing into the future.
Anything could happen next. You'd be able to travel for quite a while inside the event horizon.
But soon after that, you'll be pulled into a fireball or an infinite roller coaster of space and time, or be pulled into the singularity to meet your maker.
I don't highly recommend the experience. The idea that black holes exist
was first put up by Reverend John Mitchell in the 18th century. Modern-day physicists like Stephen Hawking have contributed immensely in this field of astrophysics and quantum research. Hawking hypothesizes
that instead of event horizons, there exists something known as apparent horizons. Anyways,
scientists claim that there are thousands of millions of black holes in our galaxy alone. They can be detected as they don't let light escape, and also through gravitational waves,
which can cause ripples through the very fabric of space and time. Black holes come in all kinds of sizes. They can be as small as the penny in your pocket right now,
or they can be the supermassive black holes found at the center of most galaxies. In fact, at the heart of our very own Milky Way galaxy lies a supermassive black hole. Sagittarius A, as it is called, is 14 million miles across.
We keep discovering new ones every day. The largest black holes we have found have masses more than 50 billion times that of our sun. But as amazing as these black holes are, they'll be eventually wiped out one day.
This happens due to a process called Hawking radiation. To understand this better, we need to take a look at empty space. Empty space isn't really empty, but full of virtual particles, transient fluctuations in space-time. These virtual particles keep popping into existence and cancelling out each other. When this happens at the event horizon of a black hole,
one of the particles falls into the black hole and one escapes out. This causes black holes to lose mass. But don't worry, eh? This process is extremely slow, and the greatest of supermassive black holes may take googolians of years to die out. Theoretically, anything can be converted into a black hole. Even you. We just need to have your mass compressed enough. So, at the end of this all, what really is a black hole? What purpose does it serve even?
Is it just a wormhole? A gateway to another universe? Or is it a time bomb waiting to explode and spawn a universe of its own? We don't really know.
Perhaps our very own Big Bang came out of a black hole in another much larger universe. There are loads of crazy ideas out there, and I'll be sure to explore them now and then. Hey, by the way, do you know I now have my own official website? There's a lot of interesting and informative stuff, and also exclusive content about my videos. Link is in the description. I'm sure you love these black holes and would want to know more about them. So I've put links in the description for your additional reading and further research. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Also, click on the red colored convex polyhedron and subscribe to my channel for new content and latest videos. Also, spread the word. Oh, and check out my other videos. I keep making new ones frequently. Well, it was quite a pleasure going out there beyond the horizon and blacking out these black monsters. See you soon. Till then, Paragon.